Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Salon Management Congress Virtual 2020, presented by Professional Beauty India. I'm Kanishka Ramchandani, the editor of Professional Beauty, and I welcome you all to this session. We will be kickstarting today's proceedings with a very interesting and debatable topic of traditional service, salon services versus home services. And I have with me a very illustrious panel of speakers from the industry. I'll take a few minutes of your time to introduce my panel to you, and thereon we will start with our discussion. So I have on my panel today four renowned names from the industry. Samir Srivastav, CEO, Jean-Claude Biguin Salon and Spa India. Samir has been spearheading the Indian operations of JCB, and his primary focus is to scale new heights and leverage key resources to achieve unprecedented growth and success for the brand. He comes with 22 years of experience with reputed global brands and multinational conglomerates. Samir has secured his MBA in management and marketing from the Birla Institute of Technology, and in his spare time, he enjoys reading, and he is also a passionate golfer. Welcome on board, Samir.
Used to be a passionate golfer. I stand corrected. Wo zamane gaye abhi. But thank you so much for the introduction, and thank you for your kind words. Happy to be here.
Great. It's lovely to have you on board for the first session of SMC. Next, I have with me Uday Takke. Uday is an internationally trained hair designer, and he is the director of Uday Takke's Hair and Skin Institution. He is a creative director of U Takke's Institute of Hair and Skin, the founder of Uday Takke Hair Care Products and Skin Amore Skin Care Products. And he's also the vice president of AIBA and the general secretary for MHBA. Hello, Uday. Welcome on board of SMC. You are on mute. Can you please unmute yourself?
Thank you so much for calling me here.
Hi. It's great to have you with us today. My third speaker for this panel is Vikram Bhatt from Enrich. He's the founder and director of Enrich Salon. He calls himself an accidental entrepreneur because he founded Enrich along with his two friends in 1997, and it all turned out to be a happy accident. Multitasking, Vikram Bhatt was a finance professional. Along with his corporate job, he devoted his weekend to bring up his retail venture. Welcome, Vikram. We are very happy to have our accidental entrepreneur in our midst today. And my fourth panelist for today is Anand Reja from Urban Company. He is the vice president of Urban Company, leading the salon business for the brand. A graduate from IIT Delhi and Harvard Business School, Anand has experience spanning across FMCG, consulting, and startups. Welcome, Anand. Thank you to all my panelists for joining me today on this panel. So this is literally taking the bull by its horns. Throughout the pandemic, we have been discussing the whole issue of how home services are taking an upper hand and salons are suffering. Whether it is true or not, or whether it is a really bad situation, or it is something of an opportunity, all these are the points that will be coming up in this discussion. So I would like to start with Samir. Can you tell us your opinion on whether the whole aspect of home services should we be fighting it or integrating it into a salon model?
No, I think very, very clear. It's a welcome. It's ultimately what the customer wants.
Right.
You know, so we in our businesses, whether I have been in this industry or in my other earlier industry, it has to go by what the customer demands. If customer wants product A, then product A. If customer wants a service at home, and if we are able to provide it, why not provide it? So at JCB, we have been doing home services for beauty for almost 2.5 years. We had a relationship with one of the earlier first movers in this space, young couple. And I think they did well. But to certain internal reasons, we said we will start off by doing this on our own. So almost about 1.5 years, we have been doing beauty services at home. We had no... And it's being offered to the JCB customer within 3 to 4 kilometers radius. Very successful from a demand perspective, from a customer satisfaction perspective. Contribution to revenue is negligible. Okay. Negligible, you know. Because see, Bombay mein people want this. They want to come out of the house. They want to come out of come and spend time in the salon. It's a release for them.
Yes.
But yet, if we say ki, no, we'll be absolutely siloed. No, we cannot offer somebody a vaccine service at home. That's really not. And I'm not talking pandemic situation. I'm talking pre-pandemic days. So it was a previous services. It has to be offered. Has been doing it, and we've had no cannibalization on it at all. And neither ye ki there is a problem from the beautician or saying nahi main customer ko directly main I'll go and service the customer main alag se. Nothing like that has happened. Like I repeatedly saying, it's a very small portion of our businesses. But yes, the business is here to stay. The vertical will be here to grow.
Yeah.
Not post pandemic is not yet over, but I think abhi, once you know the salons reopened, I think there was a huge thrust, a lot of demand from the customer. So again, my philosophy is only based on one thing: is what I have to do is what the customer wants.
Right.
So you know, let's talk more on this as we.
Yes, I would like to come back to this point of customer demand once I hear what the other panelists have to say. So Uday, aapka kya kehna hai is baare mein? Kya salons ko ye accept kar lena chahiye ki home services part and parcel hai abhi?
Ji haan. एक्चुअली हमें वो मंजूर करना ही चाहिए. सी मेरा एक ऐसा एनालिसिस है कि एक साल का बच्चा या 70-80-90 जितने भी साल हम लोग जी रहे वो सारे इंडस्ट्री के मतलब हमारे पास आते ही आते हैं. एज में अगर हम लोग ग्रुप करते हैं, एज को डिवाइड करते हैं, सो 1 से 15 साल के बच्चे जो स्कूलिंग है वो आजकल बच्चे ज़्यादा नहीं आ रहे. मतलब हमारे सलून पर कैसे फर्क पड़ रहा है. और होता क्या है कि 15 से 25 या 15 से 22 अगर हम लोग बोलते हैं तो वो है कॉलेज ग्रुप. वो भी इतना मायने नहीं रख रहा है फिलहाल के सलोन में आने का. घर वाले उनको चिल्ला रहे कि मत जाओ. फिर हमारे पास कौन सा ग्रुप आ रहा है तो एक 25-50 ये ग्रुप हमारे सलोन्स में ज्यादा आ रहा है. उसके बाद के भी मतलब 60 के बाद के भी नहीं आ रहे. तो यहाँ ऐसे लग रहा है कि अगर वो हमारे पास नहीं आ रहे तो ये भी जरूरी है कि ये सिचुएशन अभी है वो होना जरूरी है. एज पर माई एनालिसिस कि इतना ही परसेंटेज हमें बिजनेस मिल रहा है जबकि सारे लोग हमारे सलोन्स में आते थे. अब ये थोड़ा सा हमें कंप्रो करना पड़ता है कि कुछ कुछ लोगों को घर पे सर्विस दी जा रही है बिकॉज़ वो घर से बाहर नहीं निकल रहे.
बिल्कुल
कि हम घर पे सर्विस करते थे कुछ प्रॉब्लम है नहीं ऐसा मेरा मानना है.
ओके विक्रम व्हाट डू यू हैव टू से अबाउट दिस.
ओके वी हैव बीन इनटू दिस बिजनेस फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 3 years. इनफैक्ट वी एक्वायर्ड अ ब्रांड हु वाज अ पायनियर इन दिस बिजनेस कॉल्ड बेलिटा.
या
एंड आई आर लर्निंग. And in fact, when you're introducing me, I wanted to add a line that still learning home service business. Coming back to this point, it's like, you know, it depends on, there are some 3 or 4 aspects to it. One is that a salon needs to decide what services you want to offer.
Yeah.
Second, what experience you want to give it to the customers. Because remember, you're a specialist. So anything, any benchmark you've set at your salon, if you can't replicate that into home service business, then customer will question you. A couple of other things we as a salon brand has to think is that what price point and what choice of services I want to give it to the customer.
Right.
And the price which I want to offer it, whether customer is willing to pay that price for the same service in experience, or is there any shift? And last stage, definitely it has to be integrated, but it has to be a convenience business, not a price war business. I just want to reflect on what Udayji mentioned, that he's seeing a drop into young age kid and the senior citizen not coming into salon. But we have seen exactly opposite. We are seeing more kids, more what do you call, we have special rates for students. They are coming, their count has improved. In fact, senior citizens count also has increased substantially in our salons.
Okay, that's interesting. We here have two opposing views of how customer is reacting. Coming to you, Anand, I believe you've been, you as an urban company has been receiving a lot of flack from the salon industry, considering that you are eating into their space by providing home services. So what is your take on this?
No, thanks Kanishka. So
At least the way I look at it, and I'm sure others would also at least partially agree with me here. We're living in a country where less than 5% of the users use any form of organized beauty services. And lots of them, especially men, use barbers in whatever way. So we're in a country where the industry is in its infancy. It's really, really small. It's literally been started over the last few decades and it's just growing. All of us together are there to grow this industry right now. Now, users are all of different kinds.
Yeah.
Some users have preference for convenience. They would want services to be done at home. Some users prefer high levels of expertise or extremely, or even some users just prefer going out. The many, many homemakers that we talk to, for them, it's an experience to go out. And therefore, obviously, the preference will be to go out to a salon. The idea is to work together to grow this pie, not to fight it out between different models. Users will self-select, go where they want, use services. For all of us, the idea should be to provide top-notch, high-quality services and grow this market as much as possible and grow it to a level which is comparable to the Western world. It's a big, big industry. There are obviously, on a month-on-month basis, pre-COVID, post-COVID, yes, we receive flags, sometimes we receive praises, but all of us are just working towards growing the industry, not fighting it out amongst each other. That's my way of looking at it. Would love to hear others out here.
Right. So going back to your comment on giving the customer what they want, Sameer, is it feasible to have a home services model if it is not really contributing to your revenue and just doing it because the customer is demanding it? Because you have to maintain your staff, you have to provide them with, you know, products and transport even. So
sure. So it depends on the model that you employ. Okay. Urban Clap has a urban company, beg your pardon, has a very different model. I believe Enrich and GCB have a hybrid model where if I know a little about Vikram's business, but commenting on what we are doing is our hybrid business. We don't have a dedicated workforce. Our situation ये है कि existing जो workforce है वो ही travel करता है because of two reasons. One is because of expertise, and one is because of familiarity of the customer. Yeah. Right. So if Kanishka is living in Chembur and she is a JCB customer, or अगर वो अभी नहीं, अब she is for her facial, she is not able to come to a salon. She calls up JCB and her beautician on record जो पहले Kanishka का facial करती थी, वो ही जा करके serve करेंगे उसको. So it's really not about economics of the business. We, of course, standalone economics are very, very different compared to a hybrid model. We feel that with the hybrid model, though, we evaluate karte hain, as a businessman, we have to evaluate the vertical independently. But today, the financials are merged. So overall, I think it's a okay business. But like I'm saying, very minuscule. And I am looking at it only from two perspectives, especially now in the current scenario, that this business is here to stay. To say that ye business abhi customer ki taraf se demand nahi hoga, I think it's misnomer. I think we will see huge upsurge in demand. People really, really worry about their safety, and there are hordes of people who haven't stepped out as yet also, for whatever reasons. And I think they will, as long as brands like all of us are able to deliver safety, hygiene, which is paramount, to the customer's house, I think this business is here to stay. It will only grow in the future. It will never replace a salon business. It cannot impact the salon business. My personal views are ki there are some people who are saying ki bhai iski wajah se salon mein log aana band ho gaye hain. I beg to differ. I think if you consolidate that and see, this business is a business which is really going to be expanding the market, like I see.
Right.
And you will see number of times the customer visits your salon far higher. Not visit the salon, experiences the haircut far more higher when you have a hybrid model. This is my opinion.
Okay. Vikram, would you like to add to this? What is your opinion on the success of the hybrid model?
So in our case, we have a dedicated team which manages the services at home. And primarily, we focus only on the basic service in skin, which is like manicure, pedicure, facial, threading, and waxing. Because we believe doing hair at home is not easy task, especially how do you carry palette of color, and then what choices are you giving to the customer. Having said that, Yes, in these times, if our regular customer, our esteemed member, or a customer known to us requires any services, even in hair for that matter, even cut or a color or anything, and we know for sure what exactly they need, we do facilitate our existing salon team to go there. So that flexibility we need to give. And this is more of, I'm coming from our business, a relationship business, right? So if my customer has a need to it, we should go for it. Our learning, during pandemic and post pandemic, our home delivery of product, that business has increased substantially. In fact, it really helped us clocking some good numbers between April to July, because as you know, large part of our salons are in Maharashtra, which is Pune and Mumbai, and they were shut down till June end, and July were operational only alternate days and restricted hours. So in these times, we could really focus more on the product delivery business. For some unknown reason, and that is why I'm saying I'm still learning this business. We didn't see any upsurge into our home service business. We didn't search any need coming from our customer to call for technicians at home. We didn't feel our technician felt safe to reach to any customer who's not known to go in and do the service. So there were like enough reasons for us for not being able to see any growth or change in our business model.
Right. So this, what you're describing right now is something specific to the whole pandemic situation that we have faced. And over time, yes, you're right. Not you, just you, everyone is learning because the situation is changing so rapidly in different cities and states. Uday, आपका इसमें क्या ओपिनियन रहेगा कि क्या होम सर्विसेज आपके रेवेन्यू को उतना कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं?
जी संभव थोड़ा फर्क तो पड़ता है, नहीं ऐसा नहीं, क्योंकि कैसा होता है ना कि मैक्सिमम पहली बात ऐसा था कि हाँ, ऐसा नहीं कि सैलून्स में जैसे हम लोगों ने जब से बिजनेस चालू किया, काफी सालों के पहले से बिजनेस था कि घर पे जाके काम करने का, ये तो बिजनेस था, ऐसा नहीं कि सब अभी चालू किया, अभी इसको प्रोफेशनल रूप में आया गया है। अदरवाइज नॉर्मली ऐसा होता था कि कोई कोई हमारे पास नहीं आ सकते थे, उनके लिए हमको उनके घर पे भेजना पड़ता था, कोई शुभ कार्य हो या कोई कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स हो तो घर पे जाते थे। तो ऐसा नहीं कि दिस इज अ न्यू बिजनेस फॉर अस, बट अभी क्या हो गया कि जैसे सैलून्स में एक तो ये जो शैतान है ना कोरोना नाम का, मैं थोड़ा सा हटके बताता हूँ कि लोग ऐसे होते हैं कि एक शैतान आता है तो एक गांव में से एक को खाएगा। अब आधे लोग है ना कि शैतान आएगा इसलिए ही मर रहे बेचारे, मतलब शैतान खा रहा है एक को, बाकी के तो हमारे क्लाइंट पे ये असर पड़ा है बिकॉज ऑफ रॉन्ग एडवर्टाइजमेंट, बिकॉज ऑफ ये हमारे पॉलिटिशियंस ने गंदा खेल खेला है, उसकी वजह से कि लोग डरे हुए सैलून में आने को ही उनको प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है। फिर सैलून में आके इतने सारे लोगों के साथ में बैठने का, कितना भी हाइजीन, कुछ अच्छा एक स्ट्रेंजर को घर पे बुलाओ, किसी किसी का ये मायना है तो किसी किसी का नहीं, घर पे क्यों बुलाने का, सैलून में जाके बैठते हैं, वो उतना दिखा रहे, वो इतनी हाइजीन दे रहे हैं। तो ऐसे है ना कि बिजनेस है बट डर के मारे बिजनेस नहीं है, ना ही मैं ये नहीं बोलूंगा कि मुझे घर का किसी का एक्सपीरियंस नहीं है कंपनियों का, पर सैलून में बिजनेस है बट 50% है, यू कैन से 40-50% बिजनेस है। ऐसे नहीं कि पूरे सब लोग पहले जैसे आ रहे हैं, तो थोड़ा फर्क पड़ा है। अब किस
बिल्कुल
वजह से है, हाँ एक है, अभी देखो अगर लड़कियों की बात करें, वुमेन्स की बात करें, ना कुछ फंक्शन है, उनको तो चांस ही नहीं मिल रहा है, ना वो काम पे जा रहे हैं वर्क फ्रॉम होम, तो उनको सजना सवरना है, अरे हमारे सामने से मार्केट में जा रहे हैं पूरे ग्रे हेयर है, मैम कवरिंग कवरेज क्या है जाना नहीं है, अभी चलता है नेक्स्ट टाइम, मतलब कट करने वाले तुरंत कलर भी नहीं कर रहे बिकॉज उनको कोई फंक्शन नहीं दिख रहा है ना कुछ काम पे, इसलिए क्या हो रहा है, इसलिए भी फर्क पड़ रहा है, ना कि इस वजह से फर्क पड़ रहा है। हाँ एक फर्क पड़ता है, एडवर्टाइजमेंट का फर्क पड़ रहा है। एडवर्टाइजमेंट से क्या हो रहा है कि अगर आपकी एडवर्टाइजमेंट ऐसे कहती है कि डोंट गो टू द सैलून, अगर ऐसे एड आती है ना तो थोड़ा फर्क पड़ता है, लोगों की टेंडेंसी देखिए क्या है, लोग कंफ्यूज हो रहे हैं, ये मैं मानता हूँ, तो इस पे हमें थोड़ा सा कुछ करना पड़ेगा ऐसा।
तो आप तीनों की बातों से मुझे ऐसे लग रहा है कि मैं ये कंक्लूजन ड्रॉ कर सकती हूँ कि होम सर्विसेज जो आपका बिजनेस का हिस्सा है वो एक स्टॉप गैप सॉल्यूशन की तरह काम करता है कि जैसे कस्टमर को जो नीड्स होगी उस हिसाब से हम होम सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड करेंगे या नहीं करेंगे, और जो सैलॉन का फ्रंट है वो स्ट्रॉन्ग फ्रंट बना रहेगा, वो बेस फ्रंट बना रहेगा, और होम सर्विसेज सिर्फ आपको कॉम्प्लीमेंट करेंगी. एम आई राइट?
आई पार्शली एग्री टू योर पॉइंट,
यस
बट द फैक्ट इज मुझे लग रहा है सलॉन बिजनेस या होम बिजनेस, इफ आई हैव टू टॉक एज अ ओनर, विल सर्वाइव ओनली इफ इट इज प्रॉफिटेबल सस्टेनेबल और वो होगा तो ऑब्वियसली विल गो टू होम विल डू सम बिजनेस इन सलॉन सो इट्स नॉट दैट आई डोंट वांट टू डू एक्स और वाई कस्टमर हैज टू हैव चॉइस बट वेदर आई कैन डिलीवर दैट एक्सपीरियंस आई कैन डिलीवर दैट सर्विस एट द प्राइस वेयर आई कैन मेक सम मनी
ओके
Lots of new things are coming up. Maybe Anand will know this better, but suddenly last week in Bangalore, हमको एक request आया कि भाई एक society है जहाँ पे हमारे customer रहते हैं, they want to do a salon at the clubhouse. अब, you know, there are three customers who are staying there. She said कि नहीं, मेरे 4-5 friends और हैं, we have taken permission from the society.
Yeah.
Will you be able to do it? So depending, like Vikram said, ki what kind of service mix आपको चाहिए? अगर आप बोल रहे हो कि keratin अगर करना है, तो keratin थोड़ी हो सकता है,
right?
You know, या color beyond, you can never do highlights, you can impossible do anything. At most, what you can do is cut nails, polish for women. You can do haircuts for male, which is easily doable, which we are seeing on upsurge. हमने post pandemic we've started haircuts, and I think. Again, it's not a new customer which is coming in for us, JCB. JCB mein jo customer aa raha hai home services ke liye, wo hamare existing customers hain. They are high profile customers who don't want to step out because of the current situation. But lots of new things are emerging. And but yes, like Vikram said, there is a clear cut limitation on what you will do at home.
That is,
and it cannot. It's very very difficult, to, and you have to upfront say ki boss, ye ho hi nahi sakta aapke saath. मतलब वो थोड़े मैं देखता हूँ लोगों का मेन्यू आता है कुछ कॉम्पिटिटर्स का है या कुछ और लोगों का है दे आर इलैबोरेट मेन्यूज ऑफ हाउ यू आर डूइंग एवरीथिंग एट होम आई वंडर हाउ यू नो सो यू आर कॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग ऑन सर्विस क्वालिटी यू विल एंड अप मेकिंग अ मिस्टेक यू विल एंड अप हर्टिंग नॉट ओनली योर इमेज बट ऑल्सो स्पॉइलिंग समबडीज हेयर
नो नो एंड समथिंग लाइक एज लॉन्ग एज एबल टू मीट कस्टमर्स एक्सपीरियंस और एक्सपेक्टेशंस इट्स ओके अगर कस्टमर एक्सपीरियंस वो हिसाब से एक्सपेक्टेशन वो हिसाब से एंड इफ यू आर एबल टू डिलीवर इट व्हाई नॉट
श्योर
राइट आनंद व्हाट वुड यू लाइक टू ऐड टू दिस द काइंड ऑफ सर्विसेज दैट कैन बी यू नो परफॉर्मड इन द कन्फाइंस ऑफ समबडीज होम सो आपका एक्सपीरियंस इसमें डेफिनेटली ज्यादा है तो आप इसमें कुछ ऐड करना चाहेंगे
एब्सोल्युटली सो सी फॉर अस आल्सो एज विक्रम एंड समीर राइटली मेंशनड If there is a compromise on experience, that is a big failure for us also. It is a everybody knows this business runs on repeat. You want customers to come again and again.
Yeah.
And any time a consumer feels ki boss, it was a shoddy job, it could have been done better, there was some compromise, they're not coming back to you. So we've tried to experiment, we've tried to add new services first on pilots and then see wherever the experience has been good. At least expand it more. So far, we've realized hair is a tougher one. We've been trying really hard. Women's hair, men's hair obviously is fairly, and there's a good demand also. Women's hair has been tough. We've been trying at least what we've seen the very very few services where there are genuine limitations. In fact, I would disagree even keratin etc. If you actually talk, so we realize much more from our men's hairstyle is that. Whenever we go for men's services, mostly their wives ask ki aap keratin karte and then they take up a keratin service as well. So we've been trying to push the limits there. Obviously, it's a work in progress. We are yet to see how much we can really get there. But other than hair, we've seen that things are almost everything can be done with the right amount of quality, with the right amount of user expectations being met. That is at least the way we look at it. Mostly it is some form of infrastructure limitations which come up in here or some form of for example washing stations or
yeah.
things which require a prolonged service time which yes. can become a challenge
so is this the right time to run such pilots because you know given the whole pandemic thing people would not want the service provider to be in their house for longer period similarly the service provider herself would want to you know quickly finish the service and move on so do you think you guys should be waiting for the pandemic to end and then piloting treatments like keratin
no these are not just now we've been trying to launch services like these for the last 2 years so these are things which have been ongoing
okay.
and obviously we're taking care of nothing which is more than 1-1.5 hour, which is typically the maximum time which will take for a bouquet of services that we limit the exposure to.
Right, right. Also, given the way home services like Urban Company operate, you how open are you to add on more services while the customer is still doing the previous service?
Yeah, so see, the professionals do carry the entire bouquet of products that are required for all the services that are on the menu. Many a times it is users who change between different facials. So they might have booked for A but would ask for B, or would suddenly realize, let's get a pedicure also done. So this was an early experience. We realized that you cannot limit to just the services which are booked. It's not like traditional e-commerce where you book a particular product and you can't change that when it's actually being done. So you have to be completely open. Otherwise, consumers will definitely feel that they are lacking that spontaneity of making a choice while getting a service.
Right. So that is the flexibility that you need to have.
Absolutely. This is something which is fairly uncompromisable when it comes to users' likes on how they would like a service to be done.
Right. Now, going back to my three salon owners, we have been speaking about premium salons above in the luxury space, which you guys are operating. But if you were to give me your opinion on how the B and the B plus category salons should be taking on the whole home services challenge, what is your opinion about it? I have a twofold question here. One is, is it possible for the B plus category salons to integrate the home services model? And two, is it more of a competition for them to face rather than just something that they can expand into? Sameer, would you like to start?
You see, like I said, it, my first opening words is only basis two things. What is the customer demand?
Right.
As marketers, as business people, we have to see what the customer demand is. Of course, with certain filters in place. So it doesn't matter ki wo A category hai ya B category ya C category. Ab aap dekhi, traditionally, and this is a very old point that we have raised, ki logon ki ghar mein to head massage champi ke liye jate hi the. Shuru se, aaj se nahi, hamare father ke zamane se hota tha. That is happening. It. If you go to North India, where there are larger houses, bigger places, the beautician is always coming at home. Has been coming at home for many years. So it's really not depending on the fact that you are A category, B category, or C. My personal suggestion is it is here based on what your customer wants. And if you want to hold on to your customer, you have to adapt yourself.
Right.
If you don't adapt yourself, you will perish, is what I would simply say. So it really doesn't mean matter whether you're which category, which town. You have to see and manage and twist and change the model as per the environment. That was very simple to the point that I'd like to say this.
Okay, Vikram?
Okay, so what I feel, suppose main 1000 customer ko in a month main serve kar raha hun. Is this new thing what I'm trying is going to get incremental customer base or the revenue? Because my 10% 20% customer may want to come, rather may want my people to go there and give them service. That's just a kind of service. It's not going to increase the pie. So as long as mujhe lag raha hai that by adding this proposition, I'm able to increase my customer base. Mujhe incremental revenue milne wala hai. Definitely you do it. Keeping in mind all these checkpoints in place, ki kaun sa service dena hai, kitne price pe dena hai, whether that price point is acceptable to the customer or not, or what. One thing I pick up from the food industry, and I'm sure this is something to for all of us to kind of think further, is like, why Swiggy is so successful? Why Ola Chef got shut down? Because Swiggy gives me Mera Wala Pav Bhaji from Achija, Mera Wala Pav, Pulao from Laltas, Mera Wala Biryani from Sai Palace. They aggregate and give me. So tomorrow, if there is any requirement, if someone is really appreciating JCB's waxing, customers should get there through some model which can deliver at our home, right? Someone really appreciate my coloring, then should be able to book my coloring and get at home or at salon. I think these are the things someone has to think through. And I'm repeating what all other panelists have said. Home service business was there in ancient times. I would say it was salon who emerged, which emerged over a period of time and tried to create their own space. So obviously, salon will continue, I would say. There is no question about home services being not continued or what is it or how is it. And large population of India is still actually taking that service as their primary need.
Yeah.
So it's more of how do I offer that value proposition to the customer? And if it is acceptable to customer, definitely he or she will want it and my business will increase. Just jumping into it, अरे यार मैं प्रेशर में आ गया हूँ. Ask any of us, what is the revenue base? I guarantee nobody can say I'm operating at 120% versus somebody's operating at 60%. We are somewhere in the same range. Be it home business, be it salon business, be it any business. I think the need right now is to create that confidence in customers' mind. Sorry, whatever option you want to do, that we need to get the fear out of the customers. Let's work on those situations rather than trying to get into what we are not good at, because there is a time. It will take a time for each of us to learn something. It's not going to happen overnight. And if we have that patience, why not?
Right. So I totally agree with you there, Vikram. It is each to its own. If you have the capacity, if you have the bandwidth, then go ahead and integrate home services. But right now, the way the situation is and the way the players are marketing themselves, do you think that salons are a competition to home services and vice versa?
Salons are competition to home services. No, salons are not competition to home services.
No.
And I can
and
talk
vice versa.
From
our home services.
My experience for the fact that in our case, each of our customers know that we provide them home services. All of them
Correct.
Know what kind of services we provide to them. Still, my interface
right.
between people who are coming to salon and also want some service at home is only 8%.
Right. Coming to you, Uday, आपका इस बारे में क्या ख्याल है? क्या होम सर्विसेज और सैलॉन्स एक दूसरे के अगेंस्ट कंपटीशन में है या दोनों का वर्किंग मॉडल कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री हो सकता है?
सी आपने देखा होगा कि आज ये डीमार्ट है, बाद में रिलायंस, जहां पर सब सामान मिलता है, घर का सामान मिलता है, नो डाउट. हमारा जो पहला था ना, हमारा एक शॉप था जिसमें हम लोग लेते थे, लेकिन हम लोग फिर बाद में डीमार्ट में जाने लगे. वो उसके पास पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन में सबके बैंक बच गए एक्चुअली, राइट. लेकिन वो जो था ना, जो दुकानदार होता था हमारा, जिसके पास से हम लेते थे, वो एकदम फुल फॉर्म में था. और आज मैं ये बताना चाहता हूँ कि सैलॉन्स हो या भरे घर पे जाके करते हो या कोई सर्विस हो, कोई भी मरने वाला नहीं है, कोई भी नहीं है, क्योंकि सैलॉन बिजनेस भी इतना बुरा नहीं है. हाँ, शुरू शुरू में फर्क पड़ा, मैंने बताया था कि डर के हमारे लोग नहीं आ रहे, ना कि आपकी सर्विस मिल रही है आपके पास जा रहे हैं, ना ही हमारी सर्विस अच्छी इसके लिए हमारे पास. जिनको अगर जिसको मेरे पास बाल काटना है ना, वो जैसे कोई आर्टिस्ट है, मैं इन द सेंस कोई जो आर्टिस्ट है ना, उनको आप कुछ भी दोगे लॉलीपॉप तो भी वो तुम्हारे पास नहीं आएगा. कितनी भी स्कीम्स दो या कुछ भी करो, अगर आर्टिस्ट सैलून संभाल रहे खुद अच्छे से तो इतना प्रॉब्लम नहीं आता है. कुछ अच्छे नाम है उनको इतना फर्क बिल्कुल भी पड़ने वाला नहीं है. फर्क उस चीज से पड़ रहा है, मैं फिर से बताता हूँ, सॉरी टू क्लियर माई पॉइंट. फर्क इसलिए पड़ रहा है कि अभी सिचुएशन ऐसी है कि हम सबको हाथ में हाथ डाल के आगे जाना चाहिए था, चाहिए है, चाहिए, बट हम क्या कर रहे हैं कि एक दूसरे की बजाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. आई एम सॉरी अगेन कि यार ये मत करो, वो करो, ये अच्छा है, वो बुरा है, दिस इज वेरी रॉन्ग इन दिस सिचुएशन. मतलब हम हमारे इंडस्ट्री के लोग होने के बावजूद एक दूसरे को मारने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. आई एम सॉरी, तो ये नहीं होना चाहिए था. हम ये कहना चाहिए था कि दिस इज ऑल्सो गुड, दिस इज ऑल्सो गुड. हाँ, सेफ्टी मेजर्स इज एब्सोल्युटली फैंटास्टिक, आपको उस पर ध्यान देना ही होगा, क्योंकि हमारी वजह से ना ही लोग परेशान होने चाहिए, ना हमारे घर वाले. तो अगर हम एक दूसरे के हाथ में हाथ डाल के काम करेंगे तो दिस इज अवर फैंटास्टिक बिजनेस. और आज कोविड की वजह से ही हमारा बिजनेस 50% तक है, बाकी उसका कोई ऐसा मतलब नहीं कि हमारे क्लाइंट उसने लिए, उसने हमारे क्लाइंट कुछ नहीं, ये मेरा मानना है.
आप ये समझते हो कि हेल्दी कंपटीशन जहां तक है वहां तक ठीक है, लेकिन अभी जैसे हालात हैं, एक दूसरे का साथ देना जरूरी है, एक दूसरे को सपोर्ट करना जरूरी है, और किस फॉर्मेट में काम कर रहे हैं वो शायद इतने मायने नहीं रखेगा अगर हम सब साथ मिलके इंडस्ट्री के लिए काम करेंगे. ओके,
एक जैसे कि कोई लड़की घर पे जा रही है, ठीक है, कोई भी कंपनी से जाने दो, अरे यार वो लड़कियां जो घर पे जाती है वो सही नहीं होती है, गलत होती है, या उसमें कुछ उनको क्वालिटी नहीं है, इसलिए रॉन्गफुल ये नहीं होना चाहिए। या तो जो सलून में काम कर रहा है वो बरोबर नहीं है, उसका तो एकदम गया गुजरा होता है, ये भी गलत है। सारे अच्छे लोग ही हमारे इंडस्ट्री में पढ़ लिख के अच्छे बन रहे हैं और अच्छा बिजनेस करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, किसी को प्रॉब्लम से इसके लिए कंपनी के साथ जुड़े, किसी को प्रॉब्लम नहीं वो अपना सलून लेके, हमें एक दूसरे को फिर से बताओ कि हेल्प करनी चाहिए, बस इतना ही मैं कहूँगा।
राइट आनंद, कमिंग टू यू, जैसे कि अभी उदय ने पॉइंट आउट किया कि सेफ्टी मेजर्स बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट हो जाते हैं वेदर यू आर इनसाइड द सैलॉन और यू आर वर्किंग इन आउट ऑफ समबडीज हाउस, सो व्हाट वर द चैलेंजेस दैट यू फेस्ड स्पेसिफिकली इन गेटिंग योर टीम रेडी टू मीट द सेफ्टी प्रिकॉशंस द प्रोटोकॉल?
एब्सोल्युटली एब्सोल्युटली कनेक्शन। सो आई थिंक द टाइम बिटवीन अप्रैल एंड मे सिंस we were not delivering any services just because of the government rules, gave us a good amount of time to step back, understand what will be required from a consumer point of view to get that comfort, as well as be from our processes, our SOPs, as well as our checks to make sure that this can happen. The first part was just making sure that all our processes were revamped, simple things like threading not to be done through the mouth, but to be done around the neck, sanitizing each and every tool, certain other changes like not doing patch tests, etc., etc. But more importantly, at a in a distributed model where you're performing services at home, how do you make sure that people are actually complying? Because unlike a salon where you have somebody, a manager who can look at a beautician and can clearly tell if somebody is not wearing a mask, we had to use technology a lot more. Thankfully, a large part of this technology we've already created. Essentially, as a home services provider, it's our first requirement to ensure that the right person is reaching your home. So we have things like machine learning for selfie checks, where a user basically clicks a photograph, basically a small live video, as soon as they arrive at the location of the user, and the professional basically gets checked whether that's the right person. We added a lot more capabilities on testing whether the professional was carrying a bottle of sanitizer, was wearing a mask, wearing a face shield, wearing gloves. All those photographs will be clicked. That added almost 5 to 10 minutes to the entire process of doing the service. But it was something which, from a user side, created a lot of confidence from us. We saw that, yes, there was 99.99% compliance. Whenever there was a mismatch in compliance, we would take immediate action and move that out. In fact, even moving a lot of our, so normally if you've used our services, you'll see that there is a 1 to 5 rating that comes at the end. Now there was a bigger question, was the service safe? Thumbs up or thumbs down? So as to take a very clear feedback, and getting consistent ratings of 4.99, 4.98 gave us a lot of confidence that the users were completely comfortable in getting our services. Again, for us, it was not just complying and making sure that nothing, no problems like spread of disease happened, but making sure that the business could revamp, the consumers had that confidence that they could book the service without worrying so much about how this is. And word of mouth and all just spread. And these are places where I think the healthy competition between online and offline works very well, because we've seen photographs of what salons are doing, and obviously that pushes us to go all the way to ensure that we can provide a similar quality of safety features while the professionals are at somebody's homes as well.
Right. So yes, safety is a must for salon professionals, and this brings me to my next very important question, Vikram. I'd like to start with you. When safety protocols were released for salons, and there was like a huge list that you guys had to follow, did you ever consider not doing home services, keeping into account that itna sara safety protocol follow karna hai, nahi karte hain home services, too much risk hai? Kyunki salon business mein agar aapka representative ghar pe jaakar bhi koi mistake karta hai, uska repercussion salon pe aayega. To aisa kuch khayal aaya tha us waqt?
No. So as far as our process of SOP to be followed, be it salon or be it home, we have to follow it religiously and rigorously, right?
Yeah.
And then Enric as a brand, maybe as a customer, so quite a few things is in our DNA for years.
Yes.
So there is no question to it. This is more of a kind of situation where you make your customer comfortable, that as long as and as at the same time, my technician comfortable that you are going to a known client.
Yeah.
Or a customer knows that a known technician to coming to my home to give me my primordial services, right, which I might need. And then that is being done. So that faith and expectation is aligned at both ends is welcome. If any of our technicians said no, that I don't want to do it, we didn't never force them. Any of our customer, obviously my customer to puchta nahi na ki aapko bhejna hai, bhej deta hun. Like if they ask us, we give them. So there is a choice given to the customer. If they have decided to offer it, we have given. And we have ensured that we follow all possible great safety norms for customer as well as for our own people as well.
Right. What about you, Sameer? You're on mute. Can you unmute yourself?
Sorry. Picking up on what Vikram said, safety as an experience will continue to evolve. Agar humne soch liya hai ki aaj ke zamane, in fact, we at JCB are continuously looking at how do we work on this more and more. And there are more changes which are getting introduced this month.
Yeah.
Like we are thinking of, and I have nothing to hide from anyone, I'll share it with everyone, that we are now carrying a very high level of portable sanitizer from Korea. We've tied up with a company. So we are taking that additionally. We are taking a wand, which is a virus killer, which is a virus block kind of a wand. So you will continue to enhance the safety experience for sure. Just adding to what Vikram says, for example, we will ask the customer equally. We have had many cases where our people have requested that because of our team members, ki hamare aged parents hai, ya small children, there is no compulsion to do. No compulsion to do.
Right.
In fact, when a booking comes in, you would obviously, everything is available digitally. Aap log in kar sakte hain. You can go onto the BMC website. You can check which building is infected, not infected. You will ask 2-3 leading questions to your customers.
Yes.
Customers are also not careless, less or reckless, I would say, you know, let's face it from both sides.
Yeah.
So I think yeah, business safety to say that we have arrived 100 out of 100. No. Good brands like Enrich, etc., Lakme, etc., are already very well known for safety standards. But we will, as an industry, continue to evolve more and more, both in salon as well as at home. At home, it's a little more happening because you are, you know, there is the number of touch points are much more. You know, you would get out of a lift, you would go into a lift, you would, you know, use your own vehicle. You would,
is required. In home service, self-discipline is required. In salon, as Anand mentioned, it's a control environment. Manager is ensuring every possible thing is being taken care of.
Right.
Yeah. For example, every camera, sometimes at home, these are things which are missing. But yeah. I think our people, and I would say across for the industry, not just for my colleagues, I think overall, any brand that I see has really worked on self. The overall industry has improved on hygiene and sanitization. Very, very clear contribution to each one of us who operate in the industry.
No, and the fact is, in last 3-4 months, not a single such big thing got reported where a customer got something into through a therapy.
Because of salon visit, yeah.
Salon or anywhere. Right? That's a big thumbs up to our industry where we've been extra conscious about managing every possible things in the right manner.
Absolutely. Uday, aapke kya vichar hai is par home services mein safety protocols?
Perfect. Safety protocols ki zarurat hai hi hai aur acche hai, matlab aise koi problem hai hi nahi. Sirf ek hai ki company jab safety protocols de rahi hai to person, lady ya gents jo bhi ghar pe ja rahe hain unhone utna follow karna chahiye. Kahi kahi par uska jaise humko report milta hai thode se wo thode se karte hai, thoda sa neglect karte hai, chalo chalta hai to chalte hai, thoda ja raha hai. अदरवाइज उनको भी उनके हाँ उनको भी उनकी प्रिकॉशंस लेनी है, उनके घर वालों के लिए, इसके लिए वो फॉलो करते ही करते हैं और सलून में भी उतना ही कर रहे हैं, तो इतना प्रॉब्लम नहीं है क्योंकि वो जिंदगी से खेलना है, उनके भी जिंदगी से खेलना है, लोगों की जिंदगी से खेलना है, फिर पैसा बनाना है, घर चलाना है, तो उतना तो वो कर ही रहे. सो घर पे जाना और नहीं करना कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं. अभी हमारे सलून में कोई कोई शादी है तो भले सलून में सर्विस दे, लेकिन कभी कभी हमको पूछा जाता है कि हमारे चार है ब्राइड है, ब्राइड का फलाना फलाना करना है, तो हम लोग ये नहीं बोले कि नहीं हमारा होम सर्विस का नहीं है, बस हम लोग देते ही सर्विस उनको, हमारे एक्सपर्ट उनके जाके उनको जो मेकअप करना है, फेशियल करना है, वो तो करते ही करते. तो ये हैंड्स इन हैंड्स ही है बिजनेस. हाँ, सिर्फ अभी आपकी कंपनी है, आप जिनको कंपनी उन्होंने वो बिजनेस बनाया है तो ठीक है, बट हमारा भी वो बिजनेस था है, तो दिस इज हैंड्स ऑन सेफ्टी के बिना कुछ नहीं. सेफ्टी के प्रिकॉशंस लोगों ने मन से करना चाहिए, बोल के नहीं. मैं मेरे कारीगर को अगर भेजू किधर भी कि भाई जाओ और उनको फेशियल करके आ, हाँ सर आप टेंशन मत लो, उसने अगर यहाँ वहाँ टच करते करते गया, उसने प्रिकॉशन ले लिया, तो वो हमारे सर्वेंट्स को अफेक्ट करेगा।
बिल्कुल, तो जैसे कि पहले समीर ने बताया कि हम ना सेफ्टी प्रोटोकॉल्स हमारे डेफिनेटली एक हायर लेवल पे चले गए हैं पूरे सलोन इंडस्ट्री के, और उसी के साथ में हमारा ये चलता है वाला एटीट्यूड भी अभी जाना चाहिए। हमें हर हर फेज में हर कदम पर एकदम प्रिकॉशन के साथ ही बढ़ना है। और उदय, जैसे आपने बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट ये कहा कि दिल से करना चाहिए, किसी के प्रेशर में आकर या बॉस कह रहा है इसीलिए नहीं करना है, इट्स आफ्टर ऑल योर सेफ्टी आल्सो।
एक बात मैं और ऐड करूंगा इसमें
जी,
कि पहले हमारे अपॉइंटमेंट होती थी, नो डाउट अपॉइंटमेंट के बिना हम लोग नहीं करते थे, वॉकिंग भी लेते थे, नो डाउट। लेकिन अभी क्या हो गया कि उस अपॉइंटमेंट पे ना एक रिस्पेक्ट आ गया, फ्री है, एवरीथिंग इज क्लियर, मतलब वो फियर के भले फियर है इसके लिए, लेकिन अभी ना जो अपॉइंटमेंट होती है प्रॉपर टाइमिंग पे आते हैं, प्रॉपर टाइमिंग पे जाते हैं, और एक रिस्पेक्ट भी अभी ज़्यादा हो रहा है बिकॉज ऑफ सेफ्टी प्रिकॉशन। जब हम लोग उनको सैनिटाइज करते हैं बाहर, उनको शूज कवर ये सब देते हैं ना, तो एक जो रिस्पेक्ट मिलना चाहिए था इंडस्ट्री को, वो अभी मिल रहा है। मैं ये बोलूँगा कि पैंडेमिक की वजह से उल्टा ज़्यादा रिस्पेक्ट भी बढ़ गया हमारी इंडस्ट्री में, तो उनका क्या कहना है मुझे पता नहीं।
But no, in fact, if you see, probably we are the only industry which has done some huge amount
Absolutely.
Of changes in the way we operate, and that's kind of very apparent. Otherwise, today if you walk down to any society store or any supermarket, it's just one hand sanitizer is there and people are using it, not using it, nobody's bothered about it. But this one Absolutely. Industry, collectively, be it at home, be it at salon, any place you go, you see visible changes as far as safety and hygiene norms
are. Yeah, and I think complete Absolutely. Credit to whether it's home operators or it is salon yeah, operators, chahe wo chota town, agar aap dekhe, I'll take your memory back. Bahut ye picture mere dimag mein and kai logon ke dimag mein. Remember that two brothers in Punjab or three brothers who were under a tree, they are basically hairdressers the, wo ped ke niche, lekin khud PPE kit pehen ke karte. सैमसंग ये तो अवेकनिंग आई है, ओवरऑल अवर स्टैंडर्ड्स हैव गॉन अप, कितना सर्टिफिकेशन हुआ है, कितनी मेहनत हुई है, एंड देयर इज अ ग्रेट अवेकनिंग व्हिच हैज हैपेंड इन एवरीवन, एंड कस्टमर इज रियली एंजॉयिंग, एंड लाइक विक्रम सेड, आई एम श्योर आनंद एंड उदय भी एग्री करेंगे कि आपको कभी भी कोई इंसिडेंट नहीं मिला है कि भाई सलोन से स्प्रेड हो रहा है। नो वे, पिछले 4 महीने हो गए खुले हुए हमारे, नो बैड न्यूज एट ऑल,
हैव सर्वड मिलियंस ऑफ कस्टमर्स,
अमेरिका के सलोन में एक टॉवेल से हो गया, वो मुझे अभी तक समझ नहीं आ रहा कि वो फंडा किसका था, किस लिए ये किया गया, वही नहीं समझ में आ रहा, उसके पीछे किस पॉलिटिशियंस का हाथ था, इंडिया में नहीं हो रहा है। बोलो।
और समीर, ये जो पिक्चर की आपने बात कही, दिस वाज वन ऑफ द अर्लीस्ट हेयर प्रोफेशनल हु स्टार्टेड वर्किंग एंड पेड़ के नीचे, यस, एंड दे वर वेयरिंग पीपी किट, सो दैट वाज काइंड ऑफ इंस्पिरेशनल, एंड आई थिंक फाइनली इंडियन सैलून इंडस्ट्री को क्रेडिट जाएगा दैट वी आर मेकिंग द कॉमन मैन मोर पंक्चुअल फॉर रैदर नॉट जस्ट मोर पंक्चुअल बट इंडियन को पंक्चुअल बनाने का हमें क्रेडिट मिल रहा है। ओके, सो आई वुड लाइक टू राउंड अप दिस डिबेट विद अ लिटिल डिस्कशन ऑन द चैलेंजेस दैट वी आर फेसिंग एंड द कंपटीशन दैट यू गाइस आर फेसिंग। सो फर्स्टली आई वांट टू नो फ्रॉम यू, क्या दूसरे सैलॉन्स और उनके होम सर्विसेज आपके लिए एक चैलेंज है, कंपटीशन है, एंड फाइनली डू यू आल्सो रिगार्ड कंपनीज लाइक अर्बन कंपनी हु आर प्रोवाइडिंग ओनली होम सर्विसेज एज अ कंपटीशन टू योर बिजनेस? विक्रम,
सो इन आवर केस इफ यू सी द ट्रेंड हैज बीन इंक्रीजिंग, 50% कस्टमर्स आर कमिंग जनरेटिंग 70% ऑफ द रेवेन्यू, सो कस्टमर का काउंट कम हुआ है बट एवरेज बिल वैल्यू हैज गॉन अप एंड दैट इज रिजल्टिंग इनटू हायर बिजनेस। आई सी एज बिग अपॉर्चुनिटी बिकॉज माय 50% कस्टमर्स आर स्टिल नॉट कमिंग इन एंड दे विल कम बिकॉज स्लोली इन स्पाइट ऑफ केसेस इंक्रीजिंग द फियर फ्रॉम आवर माइंड इज गेटिंग आउट, राइट?
करेक्ट।
पीपल नीड इज इमर्जिंग डे बाय डे, सो आई एम श्योर व्हेन देयर इज सम पॉजिटिव मूवमेंट ऑन द क्लाइंट फुटफॉल वी विल सी फर्दर ग्रोथ एंड देन विल गेट देयर।
ओके, उदय, कंपटीशन के बारे में आपका क्या ओपिनियन है?
कंपटीशन तो नहीं है, मैं नहीं मानता कंपटीशन। हाँ, एक है कि जो सैलून्स वाले, कुछ कुछ सैलून्स वाले ना अपने उनके दिमाग में वो लेके बैठे, कि यार इसने मेरा बिजनेस खाया, उसने मेरा बिजनेस खाया, सब लोग घर पे जाने लगे तो मेरा क्या होगा। तो मैं ये देख रहा हूँ काफी सालों से कि रोने वाले रोते ही रहते हैं, कुछ भी हो भले, मैं किसी की बाजू नहीं ले रहा और ना ही किसी को गलत बोल रहा हूँ, बट अगर वो कर सकते तो हम क्यों नहीं कर सकते। अगर ये सोच के अगर हमारा बिजनेस करते तो देयर इज नो कॉम्पिटिशन। हमारा बिजनेस कैसे संभालना, क्या करना, उसके लिए स्ट्रैटेजी क्या डालना है, वो हमारा हमारा सबका ओपिनियन होता है, चाहे वो छोटा सालन वाला हो या बड़ा सालन वाला हो। सिर्फ एक दूसरे के पैर खींचना नहीं चाहिए, मैंने पहले क्लियर कर दिया। अब ये एक बात हो गई। दूसरी बात, कॉम्पिटिशन मुझे नहीं लगती, एक अच्छा बिजनेस है, अच्छे से बिजनेस करते हैं तो देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम।
In fact, important thing I want to add,
yes,
this is one business where human intervention will continue and technology only will enable us, will not create a replacement or a threat where something happened and then our business is not going to get, right? Which quite a few other retail businesses are going through.
Absolutely.
Being taken care by online and fine dining is being taken care by home delivery, food and same experience. But this is one business where our business, I don't see any such strong threat coming into the industry at all.
और एक होता है सर कि वो फैक्ट है ना, वो अभी तक कोई एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर रहा है कि जो फैक्ट है कि लेट गो हो रहा है थोड़ा सा, आज कलर करना था कटिंग के बाद में, लेकिन चलता है, कोई फंक्शन नहीं तो नहीं करूंगा, ये फैक्ट है। जो हमारा एक महीने में आता था वो 2-3 महीने में पैसे आ रहे हैं, कलर का 1,000-2,000 रुपए मुझे आज आना था ना, वो 2 महीने के बाद
स्पेंड नहीं हो रहा है, बराबर
सही है। जो फैक्ट है वो लोग एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर रहे, फिर वो बोलते कि नहीं नहीं कुछ घर की वजह से कुछ हुआ होगा, हमारा बिजनेस गया, तो ये भी थोड़ा तकलीफ है। थोड़ा सा अगर समझते हैं कि नहीं, लोगों की टेंडेंसी को समझते, लोगों के डर को समझते, लोगों को विश्वास अगर देखे बिजनेस करते तो बिजनेस हो रहा है, और लोग करने वाले बहुत है आज। ऐसा नहीं, पहले जब खोले हम लोगों ने सैलून्स तो 10%, 20%, 30% हम लोगों को इंतजार करना पड़ रहा था कि अरे भाई क्या हुआ, क्या होने वाला है, नए लोग हमारे इंडस्ट्री में कैसे आएंगे, हम लोग एकेडमी के बारे में सोचते, तो इतने सारे सवाल आने लगे मन में। लेकिन बाद में तो बिजनेस आने चालू हो गया, जैसे जैसे विश्वास होने लगा लोगों को, लोग आना चालू हो गया, और फ्यूचर में 100% अच्छा बिजनेस हम लोग वापस हमारे लेवल पे आने वाले ही है, चाहे कोई भी हो, बिजनेस सबका होने वाला है, सबका बिजनेस अच्छा होने वाला है।
Can I just add one second? The only thing which I'll just add on is, see, your question is that will you get worried about my only counsel, and I can just speak on behalf of the industry which has been feeding me for so many years, is a request to urban companies that not to show salons in a negative place. That's all. Like Uday ne bola bade sab ki ek dusre ki taang mat khicho, humko collaborate karke grow karna hai, aap apne aapko jo area mein aap hai aap wahan ke kings ho, hum apne area ke, but you know nowhere have we said or we should not be saying this. I believe you already have modified the strategy, your communications have got modified, so we're very grateful to that. I think I hear a lot of industry people saying the same message, Anand. That's all I'm saying. Like, don't show us the overall industry, you know, salons to be a
customer's mind.
Absolutely. Right. Together, that's the future. Yeah, look at the bigger picture. Yeah.
Absolutely, Samir. And like putting it very bluntly, we are not wedded to a particular business model. We are wedded to providing best services to our users. I'll just add one thing. I think, yes, there is, if you ask me, competition hai, I mean, definitely there is competition, but this is the exact type of healthy competition that is required for any industry to prosper.
Competition is important.
Exactly. You look at the car industry back in 1980s and 90s when there were one or two manufacturers, or you look at today when you have 30 different options available, which one will you prefer? Users have so much more choice. All of them have excelled at providing high quality brands, high quality safety. And it is not that any of them have a volume which is lesser than what they had in 80s and 90s. They've grown multifold. This is exactly where we are right now. Brands will keep coming. Competition will just make all of us stronger. Business model, yes, it is like a sedan versus a hatchback. Users will prefer something or the other and they will select whatever they want to. It's not that either, it's an apples to oranges comparison. You can't say that one is better, one is not. And it's not that we are also wedded to a particular thing. We are wedded to beauty. We are wedded to making sure that as many as possible beauty professionals can benefit out of it and millions of users can experience and get beauty available and accessible to them.
Great to hear.
Anand, do you foresee any players coming in home services space which are not attached to salons? Like something similar to your model?
So over the last 5-6 years, I'm sure you've seen multiple players come in, go out, as well as some players who are doing very well also. And that will keep happening because eventually, if you look at it, it's a business model which has fairly strong unit economics. It is one where you can make a decent business out of it. They will keep coming, and as I said, offline, online, whatever you might put of it, all of this just helps grow the business. I don't see that as a challenge. That is eventually something which you can't prevent, and that is something that should happen for the benefit of Urban Company as well as the entire industry.
Do you have any plans of coming offline, or should these guys be worried?
So exactly as I said, not wedded to business models. If users ask for it, so far we've seen that we managed to provide. But as I said, there are certain services which can be done better at places. It's not something that is unthinkable for us. It's not that we are just at home and we'll not think of anything else. But yes, this is something where we've had a runway of 5-6 years. We've experimented a lot, and we know what it takes to get this up and running. It's not that trivial to get the technology and everything sorted, and it's built on some time and effort and a lot of energy that has
come and see, ask Vikram. Come into physical space and dekhna fir kya maza aaya udhar.
No, but the new salons keep happening in every catchment, and that's going to continue.
Absolutely.
With your permission, I would like to take a couple of questions from the audience on Facebook.
एक हो रहा है और भी ऐसा हो रहा है कि हमारे कारीगर जो है जिनको हम लोगों ने अगर एकेडमी से बच्चों को तैयार किया तो कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं, बट जो स्टाफ को है ना, काफी सारी कंपनी से फोन आते कि क्या भाई तू हमारे पास काम करेगा क्या, तो वो एक गलत फंडा जा रहा है. क्योंकि अलीम को फोन आया था कि क्या आप हमारे कंपनी में काम कर सकते हो, तो अलीम बोल रहा कि बोलो कितना पगार दोगे. अलीम क्या मतलब, ये जो हो रहा है ना कि एक दूसरे की टीम को तोड़ना, एक दूसरे की टीम को फोड़ना, ये थोड़ा सा जो मेन लोग है, जो सीईओ है, वो लोगों ने सोचना चाहिए, उनकी कंपनी को बोलना चाहिए कि एटलीस्ट ऐसे काम मत करो. जो वेकेंट है उनको उठाओ, बट जो ऑलरेडी काम कर रहे हैं उनको मत उठाओ.
वो एक्चुअली दिस इज अ सब्जेक्ट फॉर अनदर डिबेट ऑल टुगेदर, पोचिंग इन द इंडस्ट्री. ये तो
दिन भर लग जाएगा.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, दिन भी शायद कम पड़ जाए.
ऑन द करियर प्रोग्रेशन इन दिस इंडस्ट्री, जो भी टेक्नीशियन है, ही और शी हैज टू डिसाइड वेदर अ पर्टिकुलर चॉइस ऑफ बिजनेस, बीट होम और सलोन, इज इट गिविंग मी करियर चॉइस, इज इट गिविंग एनी प्रोग्रेशन टू मी. मैं आज एक्स लेवल पे हूँ तो मैं सीनियर बन सकता हूँ, मैं क्रिएटिव बन सकता हूँ, या मैं पेडिक्योरिस्ट हूँ तो मैं ब्यूटी थेरेपिस्ट बन सकता हूँ, मैं ब्यूटी थेरेपिस्ट हूँ तो हेयर स्टाइलिस्ट बन सकता हूँ. बिकॉज दीज काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स वी हैव एक्सपीरियंस इन आर ट्रेडिशनल मॉडल, वेयर पीपल हैव सीन द करियर चॉइसेस, राइट? सो आई एम श्योर व्हिचएवर मॉडल वी ऑपरेट, वी नीड टू गिव दैट करियर ट्रैक टू ऑल आवर टीम मेंबर्स. एट द एंड ऑफ द डे देयर सक्सेस इज आवर सक्सेस.
Absolutely. Yes, quick Absolutely. Questions, please. What are they?
So, Ashok Paliwal पूछ रहे हैं आनंद जी से. आनंद जी, आपसे ये पूछना है कि आपकी फिल्म एक्टर सलोन इंडस्ट्री के खिलाफ बोलना कब बंद करेंगी?
कब बोले हैं? नहीं नहीं, but
any clarification that you want to give on this?
No, absolutely. And I think some comments have been misinterpreted also, but it is nothing that. We are a part of the salon industry. So saying anything against the salon industry, saying something against our own business. So not that I know of anything like that. And if certain things have been misinterpreted, would like to clarify that completely. There is absolutely no prejudice against any business model within the salon industry as well.
Right. Thank you for that clarification, Anand. Rest of the comments are... actually just comments, they are not questions, but I'll still read them out for you. Sunil Bajaj keh rahe hain, it is the quality of service that matters at a good price, leave the rest to the customer. I think this we have already discussed. And Vishakha Shah Doshi is saying that it will never be a competition between salon and home services. So each will operate in their own fields, and at the end it's the customer's choice, right? All right, panelists, thank you so much for joining me today and having this really healthy conversation about home services and traditional salons. It was great to get to know your opinion. And any closing words, comments that you would like to say before we end this session? Any advice that you would like to give to salons?
I think Vikram,
माय बेस्ट विशेस टू ऑल आर कलीग्स, ऑल आर प्लेयर्स. सीजन टाइम आ रहा है तो आई एम श्योर कलेक्टिवली इफ यू वर्क ऑन अ स्ट्रॉन्ग मैसेज दैट आर सर्विसेज, आर बिजनेस, वी ऑल आर सेफ, इफ यू आर सेफ, आई थिंक दैट्स समथिंग वी ऑल नीड टू वर्क ऑन एंड इंक्रीज द पाई, गेट बैक टू द ट्रैक.
आई थिंक दो चीज आपको यही ध्यान देना पड़ेगा कि देखिए एक टिपिकल ह्यूमन मेंटालिटी, जब कोई भी चीज ज्यादा होने लगती है तो उस पर हम लोग कॉम्प्रोमाइज करने लगते हैं. एज यू एंटिसिपेट, एज यू गेट इनटू बेटर टाइम्स, वी आर ह्यूमंस, देयर इज बाउंड टू बी सम कैच व्हिच विल गेट ड्रॉप. बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली ये इस समय कैच ड्रॉप करने का टाइम नहीं, राइट टिल फॉर द नेक्स्ट. अगर हमने 2-3 महीने इतनी अच्छी सेफ्टी डेमोन्स्ट्रेट करिए ताकि हमारे 50-55% कस्टमर कॉन्फिडेंस है और वापस आ रहे हैं, whether they are doing it at home, whether they are doing it at salon, we will have to do those. And as captains of the team, every manager every day has to only talk one thing, is your own safety and your own customer safety, believe me, nothing else. Abhi to agle 6 mahine tak ya 6 mahine ke baad bhi forget the vaccine ka baare mein kya nahi aa raha. Yeah, this is normal, this is the new normal. Do not let that catch drop. Absolutely right. That's only one line.
Anand, anything you like to say before we end the session?
No, absolutely. I think Sameer hit the head there. Very important. Let's make this an ongoing process. This has actually improved our processes. Even years later, this will be something which will define the industry. Let's keep doing that. Let's keep innovating. Let's keep getting better and better products in the market as well. That is all. That is all. Customer is king, and that is what we should always remember and work towards.
Right. Uday?
Queen, sorry.
बस बिजनेस को ऊपर उठाने के लिए अच्छे लेवल से काम करना है, ना किसी को गिराओ, ना हमारे लड़कियों को जो घर पे जाने वाले उनको कुछ बुरा मत बोलो, ना सलून वालों को बुरा मत बोलो, हाथ में हाथ डाल के अच्छे से बिजनेस करो, सारे लोग ऊपर जाएंगे अच्छे से बिजनेस करके. इतना मैं मतलब प्रे करूंगा, इट्स वेरी नाइस बिजनेस एंड हम लोग अच्छे से करेंगे बस.
All right, on that very positive note, I will be ending this session. A request to my viewers to join us again at 2 p.m. for our at 1 p.m. for our next session of Salon Management Congress Virtual 2020. This is Kanishka Ramchandani signing off. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Bye.